Hi, and welcome to another episode of Straight Up Tech. Let's learn together. I hope you are now familiar with the two types of player movement and the camera movement, and I will link both the videos above so you can check it out. Now, today we will learn to set up our play area for our game, Maze Ball. So first, let us jump into Unity before we start. I have a new game, Hexer 2.0, which is now live on Google Play Store, so you can check it out. So let's open our project, Maze underscore ball. Okay, let's start. So now we are in Unity. Now we will set up our play area so that our player can move inside that area. The play field of our maze game will be fairly simple. Now I'll tell you what we are going to do. First, we'll set up the wall around the edges so our player does not roll off the edge, and then we will make different wall objects and place it randomly on our game field so it starts to look like a maze. So before I start with the walls, let me tell you what these tools actually do in the top here. Now first, you see it is look like a hand tool, and with this you can actually move your screen around according to your need. This here is the move tool. With the move tool, you can click on the object and you can move it wherever you feel the need. Let me change this again. This y was 0.5. Oh, sorry, 5. Okay. This is the rotator tool. With this you can rotate the objects and according to your need. As usual, you can move it 360 degree anywhere you want. Then you have the scale tool. With this you can scale the object, you can make it bigger, smaller, whatever your preference may be, and it all depends on what type of game you are making actually. This is the rect tool, and this I will tell you later on when it mostly comes into use when we are using text objects. So this is all these tools are about. So now let's start with making a wall around our play area. First we'll do game object, then we'll go to 3D objects and make a cube. You'll be wondering how we can make a wall from a cube. So this is what we'll do. We'll select this. We'll put this back to reset position. So it is on reset. Change this position to 0.5. So it is just above the ground. Now what we'll do is, now we need to scale this object to this whole field. So we'll put the x-axis to 20. You see, now it is covering the whole field, and z-axis to something like 0.5. So it looks like a ball. Now you can see it from the y-axis. See, this looks like a ball, and we'll put the name as North Wall. Enter. Now we'll move this object all over to the end of the field. We will duplicate this, right click, duplicate, and move this wall all over to this other end, and we will name it South Wall. After this, we will again make a duplicate of this, bring it in between, then rotate it around its y-axis. See, it's perfectly in position. Then we will move it to this edge. And name it East Wall. Then again we will duplicate this and move it all the way to this edge. And name it west wall. Okay, so this, now we have set up our play area and the ball will move in between this area, but since we are drawing a maze, so let me just change the position of my player to the starting point. I guess I'll put this as my starting point. Now I'll make some random walls inside this play area so it looks like a maze. Again, we'll do one thing: game object, 3D object, cube. Same, we will position, the position is good. So we'll scale it to something like say 10. Okay, now this is half of this. We can move it to this position, go in closer. This is much more better, just touching it. Okay, then you name it as maze wall 1. Now you can just duplicate it according to your need, and I'll speed up the process. So now it is looking something like a maze. I'm not a very good level designer, so I'm very sorry for that. Now if you press play, you can easily move between this maze. See, and the ball is also not falling off. But this is all for today's video. I hope you will try your own maze and different patterns according to your choices. So don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video again. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day.